I'd like you to take a moment and look at something you have right in front of you, your hands. 29 bones, 29 joints, 123 ligaments, 34 muscles, over 48 nerves that actually have a name in addition to countless others, and 30 major arteries that also have a name. One of the most amazing bits of God's engineering you'll be exposed to. Hands can be poetry in motion. They can be used to build very precise machines or beautiful works of art. They can be used to communicate, most thoroughly if you know sign language, but we all know, you can tell from a touch how a loved one is feeling. Hands can be used to caress a child. When properly trained, they can be used to deliver a death blow. They are our primary means of interacting with the world, which is why if you were to go into Pocono Medical Center on a Friday night in the emergency room, one-third of the injuries statistically would be injuries to people's hands or the upper arm. People had been interacting with the world and gotten injured for it. They are Jesus' way also of interacting with the world. And here at the very beginning of the Gospel of Mark, we see Jesus using his hands to reach out and touch and heal a leprous man. Quite literal here. Jesus is touching. And what I love about this is he reaches out, and in healing him, understand it says he was unclean. That does not mean he was dirty in the literal sense. He was ritually unclean. He was cut off from communion with his fellow people and from God. He was not allowed to enter the temple because of his leprosy. Uncleanliness meant isolation. Jesus, in healing him, restores him to communion both with the people around him and with God. What I love about this is that we see here the God who has been at work from the very beginning. You think back to that Genesis story, and God's kind of down in the dirt playing, and he makes a human being out of mud and then breathes his spirit into him. This God in Jesus Christ is still getting his hands dirty. For in touching the leprous man, Jesus makes himself unclean too. God's still getting his hands dirty. We should put in mind of that passage, 2 Corinthians 5:21. For Paul reminds us that for our sake, he made him to be sin who knew no sin. Jesus, becoming dirty by touching this man, by becoming unclean, makes the man clean. Just as in coming to earth, taking on the burden of our sin. He who knew no sin became sin, that we might not suffer sin's consequences. By his touch, Jesus makes clean. By his stripes, we are healed. Though Christ himself is wounded in the process. We are called to be imitators of our Master and Lord in this way. We are called to use our hands to reach out and touch people, to heal them in his name. We're called to bear one another's burdens and so fulfill the law of Christ. Galatians 6:2. Even if it means we get a little dirty ourselves. Our new class of Stephen ministers will be commissioned today. I look around the room and I see them. They are being trained or have been trained to do very intentionally what all of us are supposed to do as members of the Christian family, parts of the body of Christ. We are called to bear one another's burdens, but our Stephen ministers are also called to gather together regularly and debrief about what they're going through so that those burdens do not become a crushing load for them. This too we are supposed to do. I have a friend who, as he approaches the end of his ministry, is having a very rough time right now. Because he spent about 10 years of his ministry debriefing soldiers coming in from the front lines. Some of them were special forces and black ops warriors. And now he suffers nightly nightmares. Imagining himself going through what they went through. He took on their burden, now it's crushing him. So he comes to his pastor, to his church, to be relieved of that burden. The whole Christian community is to be doing this. And we do it through worship. We gather from sitting under good Christian teachings, for prayer, in small groups to support one another. This is why in the book of Hebrews we're told, do not neglect meeting together, as is the habit of some. Or as they say in the alcoholics community, which I love the saying, is 7 days without meeting makes 1 week. W-E-A-K. The full passage from Hebrews reads like this. Hebrews 10, 24 and 25 says, let us consider how to stir up one another to love and good works, not neglecting to meet together, as is the habit of some, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the day drawing near. We are called to come here and gather together and sit under the word of God and be ministered to through that word by Christ himself. Let Jesus touch us and relieve us of our burden, just as he touched and relieved the leprous man. Today's reading is, we cannot do for others what has not been done for us. We cannot give away to others what we do not possess. And so we come with empty hands and let our Lord fill them. We may have something to give away to a hurting world. At his death, Martin Luther was found to have one slip of paper in his pocket with very few words on it. And this is what it read. We are all beggars. This is true. We are all like that man in today's reading who came and simply begged Christ for healing. We have nothing to offer, but Christ has everything to offer. He gives it to us, that we may give it away to others. And this is why we keep at the spiritual practices of worship and Bible reading and prayer and Christian counseling, being a support to one another. And when we do that, we will discover that it is Christ who is at work among us, doing more than filling our hands, but claiming them as his own. 1 Corinthians 6:19 and 20 says, do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit within you, whom you have from God? You are not your own, for you were bought with a price. So glorify God in your body. We don't know how God will call us to glorify him. He'll call us to use our hands on his behalf. Adventures can come in unexpected places and unexpected ways. On April 12, 1945, about 45 miles off the coast of Japan, a crew was flying a B-29 Super Fortress on a bombing run. They were flying under radio silence, and they needed to coordinate their attack. So they did so by means of flares. These flares were phosphorus canisters about the size of a canister of tennis balls. They were primed by a technician. He pulled the cord, dropped them down a chute. They dropped several hundred feet outside of the plane where the phosphorus was exposed to the oxygen in the air and burst into flames, burning at about 1,300 degrees. As they were about to make landfall, a man named Henry Eugene Irwin was told by his commander to go back and find the flares. he did. The first one dropped out successfully, ignited in the air, and started beginning the coordination of the attack. The second one dropped successfully. On the third one, it didn't go down the canister. Exploded into flames in the crew cabin. The flares were round, and so it was just a matter of moments, maybe even seconds, before it heated up the metal around it to such a degree that the fuel tanks burst and the plane exploded, killing all on board. Not having really time to think, but simply knowing what needed to be done, Henry Irwin reached out and grabbed that canister with his bare hands. Burning at 1,300 degrees, he got it to the chute that needed to go down and threw it out of the plane, saving all on board. The lead plane turned around and headed immediately back to take him for medical care. He was not expected to survive. Within hours, before the plane touched the ground, he was awarded the Congressional Medal of Honor. The fastest award in history. Over the next 30 months and 41 surgeries, he reclaimed the use, the partial use of one hand and his eyesight. He died in his 80s. Not having only served his country, but as a father and a grandfather faithfully for many years. In a critical moment, he used his hands to save his crew. Just take a moment and look at your hands again, because these are not your hands. Your body is not your own. You were bought at a price. These are Jesus' hands. What does he want to do with them today? He's given you a part in that. Our denomination says it's God's work and our hands. I think it's God's work and his hands. You have been baptized into Christ. These are Jesus' hands to touch the world and bring healing. As he has healed you, so now he desires to heal others. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, how blessed we are to know your love for us that has made us clean and torn down the walls that separated us from you, from one another. Lord, though it may not cost us the use of our hands as it did Red Irwin, we ask that you give us the will and the courage to use these hands in front of us the way you want them used. Help us to respond to the needs of the beggars around us, remembering that we are beggars ourselves. Help us to be quick. Compassionate, that your will might be done on earth as it is in heaven. We pray this through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. take a moment, look at your hands again. Because these are not your hands. Your body is not your own. You were bought at a price. These are Jesus' hands. What does he want to do with them today? He's given you a part in that. Our denomination says it's God's work and our hands. I think it's God's work and his hands. You have been baptized into Christ. These are Jesus' hands to touch the world and bring healing. As he has healed you, so now he desires to heal others. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, how blessed we are to know your love for us that has made us clean and torn down the walls that separated us from you, from one another. Lord, though it may not cost us the use of our hands as it did Red Irwin, we ask that you give us the will and the courage to use these hands in front of us the way you want them used. Help us to respond to the needs of the beggars around us, remembering that we are beggars ourselves. Help us to be quick and compassionate, that your will might be done on earth as it is in heaven. We pray this through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. this time, I'd like to invite the congregation to be seated and invite forward our new class of Stephen ministers, as well as our Stephen readers.
Yes, I'll hold on.
Ellie, Carolyn, thank you.
Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of compassion and God of all comfort, who comforts us in all our troubles, so that we can comfort those in any trouble with the comfort we ourselves have received from God. Whatever you do, work at it with all your heart, just working for the Lord, not for men. You will receive an inheritance from the Lord as a reward. It is the Lord Christ who works for
us. Brothers and sisters, each of you has been comforted by God, the good news of Jesus' life, death, and resurrection for you. We ask you now to join in serving our Lord and those in our congregation and neighborhood who need to be comforted. As the Lord Jesus took the burdens of the world on his shoulders, has been friend to you in troubled times. We ask you to be friend to those who are hurting and the distress of daily life. As the Lord Jesus has broken down barriers that separated you from God, we ask you to heal divisions wherever you find them and strive to make them whole.
Are you prepared to meet those requests that we ask for? So, are you prepared to nurture the skills you have learned and use them to service others, to support, encourage, build up, and other people from all over the
world? Yes, Lord, the heart of God.
And the congregation of St. Paul's, Christ Hamilton. Open your hearts to the ministry of these people and to pray for them, that they may be effective servants of Christ. Are you prepared to meet this request? If so, answer yes with the help of God.
Yes, yes, with the help of God.
We also ask you to accept their ministry when you need help, to allow these individuals to work with you as you face struggles in your life, that you might receive support and help from your Christian brothers and sisters. If you are prepared to meet this request, answer yes.
you intern Peter Roberts. Work hard, use the skills you have learned, releasing the gifts and talents the Spirit of God has given you, that you might be a blessing to the people you need to be here. Continue to study, reflect on the situation you encounter, pray for the people who lie in your life to share. Be free to share your personal frustrations and needs with others so that you might receive the same kind of care and love you offer others. Act boldly and without fear, for Christ is with you. And may God peace sanctify you totally. And may your spirit and soul and body be kept sound and blameless at the coming of our Lord.
Let us pray. Oh God, we ask you to take our sister Marion, our brothers, Andy, Bud, and Bruce into your care. You have blessed them with particular gifts and talents, provided them with an opportunity to learn more about helping people. May they serve you with the power of the Holy Spirit. May they be quick to serve, patient and listening, willing to share themselves with people. Give to us thankful hearts for them, and show them in times of stress and satisfaction a special measure of your mercy and joy. Keep them strong in the faith you have given them for the sake of Jesus, who cares for all of us in every way forever. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. By this way, this is an opportunity to turn around and face our congregation. So we see the faces of our Stephen ministers, so you know who to call upon in need, and to thank them for their service. Let us now all rise and together confess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed found on page 85 of your brief. I believe in God,
Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, He rose again. He ascended into heaven. Seated at the right hand of the Father, He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Let us pray for the whole people of God, Christ Jesus, and for all people according to their needs.
Blessed Heavenly Father, the tempter's voice that once beguiled our parents in the garden speaks anew to each of us every day. We have listened, and we have sinned. And in our shame and in our foolishness, we have tried to hide from you, fearing that because of our sin, we cannot stand in your presence. There is forgiveness. Turn us again from the voice of the tempter to trust in your steadfast love and your redemption. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Lord God, sometimes we lose heart in the face of pain, obstacles, or evils that seem too great to endure. We see and are inspired by the examples not only of those who were great in the faith before us, but your children around the world who endure great hardship simply for the privilege of bearing your name. Strengthen us by their examples, that we might in our time and our day act courageously for the gospel. Lord, in your mercy. Lord God, as you raised your Son from the dead, so raise up your church for the tasks to which you call her. Bless her with faithful bishops, pastors, teachers, and ministers at every level. Guide the work of her institutions, her seminaries, schools, and social service agencies. Send your Spirit into the lives of all the baptized, that through them, grace might extend to more and more people, increasing our joy and thanksgiving to your glory. Lord, in your mercy. Lord God, we pray for those who suffer in mind, body, or soul. We ask you to be with them. Remember before you at this time, Ellen Marvin, Fred Beaton, those whose names we offer to you now. Lord, in your mercy. Lord God, for all those who plant and tend the fields in these days of springtime, pray that through their labors many may be fed. For those who engage in any honest labor, that by their work our nation might prosper. For those in the arts who shape our culture, that their influence may be wholesome and uplifting. For students who anticipate the joys of summer, that their vacations might be filled with the beauty of your creation. For those who love their neighbors, they may know that their actions are pleasing to you. For those who seek employment, that in finding it, they may contribute to the greater good of all. Lord, in your mercy. Lord God, we pray especially for those for whom the brightness of this day is darkened by the shadow of death, remembering especially the family of Constance Kern. May they be strengthened and blessed by the hope of the resurrection to everlasting life, made sure through your Son's resurrection. Lord, in your mercy. Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Now may the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Please turn and share a prayer for peace with those around you.
the Lord our God.
It is right to give Him thanks and praise.
It is indeed right and salutary that we should at all times and in all places offer thanks and praise to You, O Lord, Holy Father, through Christ our Lord, who rose beyond the bounds of death and on this day, as He had promised, poured out Your Spirit of life and power upon the chosen disciples. At this the whole earth exults in boundless joy. And so with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise Your name and join their unending hymn.
Our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to His disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is My body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of Me." Again, after supper, He took the cup and gave thanks and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in My blood, shed for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of Me." Remembering therefore His life, which was our example, His death, which forever destroyed the power of death over those who love and trust You, His resurrection, which is our own hope of glorious eternal life, and His promise to come again, we are bold to call You Father and pray as He taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be Thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For Thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Gifts of God for the people of God. Come all who are hungry to the table of salvation.
Thank you.
Please rise. And now may the body of our Lord Jesus Christ and his precious blood strengthen and preserve you unto eternal life. Amen.
Spirit, bless you now and forever.